Well, the result of MBA Small Talk, a lot of times during discussions we are having in our office, the question I raise is, do I really have to think about this? I'm one of I'm mostly only using MBA Small Talk and creating things like ready and status. And for example, about garbage collection or about persistency formats, I don't want to be thinking about that kind of technologies. And I ask mostly Wouter and my colleagues, Wouter, I think I shouldn't be thinking about this. Can that be solved? I don't want to think about deployments. It should be a button click for me. And that's that I think is in a nutshell how we make progress, always asking ourselves, or at least the modelers that are using MBA Smalltalk, if they're asking themselves, do I really need to think about this? Okay, now we come to the execution. As said, we already started in 2003. I have some screenshots that shows a bit of the progress. Unfortunately, you can only have screenshots of the user interface, but also try to explain a little bit about the technology behind it, because we made some iterations which had with big impacts, like completely changing the architecture, because they all had reasons. Well, the execution, MBA Smalltalk in a nutshell, we have the model descriptions, which is called the model description language, an editor to add, to change or manipulate those descriptions. A code generator, it's not in the first generation of our product, but in the second you have a code generator that from the model descriptions, Smalltalk code is created. In the first version you have an interpreter built within Smalltalk, and all the model descriptions were inside the database, and then those were written by the virtual machine, and then an application was created, but no small control was generated. It was also, the reason was because at that time we still thought that we should be able to have contract business managers to give them the ability to create their own contract structures. And those people don't create smaller codes. They don't think in smaller code. We have to make up our own language. But later on, first of all, because we were not successful in the contract management market, but also the interpreter was much too slow. Plus, I think also important, we experienced that even though you make it an easy editor, thinking about contract structures, for example, and thinking about relations between all involved parties or discount rules, is still a kind of development, and you need to like to think about, well, logic concepts like all E is B, or B is A is B, non-A is B, and if you do not like that, somehow it's very difficult to make a system which supports business managers. So we also left that goal. We also have a renderer to render the HTML based on the model description language with some styles. I would like to show you how that works. We have a configuration aligner builder. It's from a library published by Soaps on the Symptom Repository. We extended it a little to fit into MBA Smalltalk. We have an auto deployer that you can deploy from a dashboard very easily. You can see all our images that are running on our server park. Then we can, with a button, we can deploy new images. We have a repository, and we have also a monitor, which monitors our systems, kind of a heartbeat system. I'll come to that later, only first time left, the last four bullets, of this slide. I'll mainly now focus on the first four parts. So first, model description language. Our most important building blocks are schemas and slots. Those are most easily explained when I give the demo, so that will follow shortly. The editor, had several editors during the last 5 years. Well, this was the first editor. That was shown at the ASIC 2005, I think. You build your system 100% web-based. There was also no Smalltalk code involved. You just filled the database and interpreted what's in the database, and then an application was imported. Now here you see, it's viewable in the back. But
a little larger would be welcome.
How?
No, but it's not essential.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if you remember the presentation, but we had a lot of lists. We had a list of all the classes. It was okay when you only had 10 classes or so. It's called, by the way, schemas. You only had 10 or so, and then within that schema you had a list of slots. It was also okay if you only had about 20 slots. Then when you picked the slots, you had about 20 properties you could set. And that was also okay if you only had 20 properties. But when I was using this system, after a while, we didn't have 10 classes or tables, but a couple of hundreds, and I was unable to, with this editor, to develop the model. It was part of the first version. The second version, we still had the idea we should have a web-based development system. For people, also the modelers should log in, and so also all the changes to the model are logged, who did what. It's a screenshot people will recognize. And also we had with refactorings and navigation that was made easier. But still, but then we thought we would like to have something, well, maybe you could compare it a bit with morphing, that when you see the end user web page rendered, I would like you see a field, and you would like to edit it, the behavior behind it, would like to go through to it directly. We still have this kind of functionality, but less as shown here. That I'll show you also in the demo, that from the web application can go directly to the code. Also part of the third version. The last version, it's you're back into Smalltalk. Mostly because also my arm did hurt. Because using a web browser, you still have to use a lot your mouse. And the model was quite huge, and we had our own repository. We had a debugger that didn't function, and then we thought, first of all, from the model descriptions, we're going to generate Smalltalk code, bring that back into the VisualWorks browser, so we can use the refactoring browser, for example, and also we can use Store as a repository. So that's the last version, and we are still using this one, but we are having a lot, it's an intermediate version, because we already have a lot of ideas for the next version that will be again back into a web-based system. I come into the demo, and I'll build the system. I will show you how we build and generate the code, and how in this case, HTML is rendered. Okay, the last version is a combination with a little bit system, maybe some ideas for Morphic, and you can even click when you have the right, you click the top debug, then on all the aspects on your page, the decoration appears. You can click on it, and then you go. The Smalltalk web browser opens that particular description that belongs to this, for example, address. And you have something, some more. This taskbar above is only for modelers. You can inspect the subject, you have the slot picker, and all that stuff. Okay, now the demo comes. I have a small demo. With a concept like person that has employment with zero or more organizations. First, a bit about a little bit more about the small factoring browser for people that are working with it daily. Maybe they will see the differences. But for you using MBA Smalltalk, you first of all use a lot of pragmas. It's just an implementation way. You get them also on the class side, you get them in the database. With the last version, you get pragmas right in the method. Using dynamic protocols, which is on the single repository also, we made that then be aware of the pragmas. So if I want to see, for example, all the slot values, then I click on that particular protocol, and then this is a type of value. And, oh, there. And this way, it's I have easier for me to navigate. And also using this list pane, you can see all the instance variables. Also, instance variables are just an implementation. This modeling, you have nothing to do with instance variables. They're all created for you. And you also have them implemented in a different way without instance variables, but because of speed reasons, you can reintroduce them. And here you can also see when types are, when you are able when we are sure about the types, we show them. You're always sure about the types, but because these two slots I've removed again for purposes of the demo, and they're still in the list, so the list is not updated right. Okay. Here I have a script. Which I'll go through. First of all, I will log in to the system. I already have a login. I will show you what I've prepared for the demo. It's not much, but then you can see why we have login. I made a menu box, which is part of the subclass module. I said which classes or schemas to contain, person, organization, and reporting. So which label it should have, it's called ASUC, it should be shown in the menu tree. That's the first thing you should do. Then all our systems are unfolded only when you have a contract with us. So I made a contract, I set the contract which modules are included. For example, ASIC, the ASIC module, and that this contract is able to use it. And then you create logins. A login belongs to a contract. And I also click and say yes, this person is allowed to use the ASIC module. That's enough. Then again, as a moduler, you can take over his login. And I see the system, the way he sees it, and he has his login has authority to use the admin administrator module. I can change the login and contracts and the ASIC module. I have three schemas, a person, organization, and report. This is not rendered as I wanted to render it, but okay. The person is completely empty, but I made prepared some tabs already, so we can go a bit of speed to all the types of slots we are supporting, and those types of slots are enough to create business administration systems that we have to create. Now, first of all, if I have a person, I would like to give the person a name. Type of slot, a value slot, and give the data type, in this case a string. freestanding method. Now I have a string field, where I can put in a name. Also the database is created. I will show you also how that's done. The small is created. I will also show you how it's that done. I will now a little bit add some properties, so we have a more sophisticated field. And then we go into the details behind it. The most simple is a value slot of type string. So what is normal to add to such a slot? As you can see, by the way, this variable is also created. What I've added is I'm going to give a label to the slot, is mandatory true. Sorry, I should take the laser. Okay, I'll try to get it. And is visible in the style, in this case list, also I put this one true. Okay. When I go back to that, resync the method. Now it has a name, it also has what you can change is a mandatory field, and I also made it visible in this, which means save this person. Resync and it generates the necessary Smalltalk code, which I will show you how that's done later on. And it updates the database. Yeah, that's what it's done. And it runs much more speed. The application has much more speed than what we used to have. It was all dynamically. Now it's all generated. Yes?
So you see that your attributes, you mix logical structure attributes and presentation.
Yeah, we do. There are actually three types of properties: unique properties, behavior properties, and data format properties. But now we have all in within this as pragmas with the slot, close to the slot. But you could have editors that are only focused on, only show me the UI slots, only show me the data format slots. I also think that's a working style. First of all, I drop in a lot of slots. Then I would like to see the presentation. I'm only focused on the UI slots. And later on, in the application, I'm thinking about the constraints, the data types. So like, is it mandatory or not? Is there how are the backrefs? Is it one to one, one to many? And that's a working style. Now at this moment we do not properly support such a working style, but that's I think that belongs to the editors. And now we are having this inside the pragmas, inside one slot, so we have actually view and behavior, something that seems to belong to each other maybe, but
maybe we do it more than no.
Well, what you can do is have this person have no UI at all. You can make person view schema. It only has views. Then it should be when it's saved, should be synced with the model person. With our experience, we now have between 500,000 business concepts, at least 600, and it's no problem. That when we had a view and a model, we would have 1,200 concepts to maintain. I would cut it in half. But I was also scared. Shouldn't we have a model and a view and clear separation? Well, it's not we have problems, but it's not part of the problem at all. One thing to think about.
What's the behavior?
I'm sorry?
The behavior. You see that you have three kinds of
UI, user interface, behavior. For example, when you have a list, what elements are in the list? For example, the behavior. And data format, if it's a string or a date. Or if you see later on a method or an action or all kinds of relations, you have to do with format.
How do you specify, for example, can you have a group like things to validate what is in the list?
Yes, you have validation.
So how this is done? Is it only a block?
No. We have, like, we, for example, one integer, like how you choose an integer, you could have that specified also in pragmas, even not above 100. We have much more complex validations of that. For example, people have what they call in the Netherlands flex contracts. And to validate those, it's just write small dot code. And you can't also do those in pragmas because it depends on the age of the person, how much contracts already had in the past, and it's complicated code. So we did it now. We only do it in a certain way, so we can handle just very small ones, like the starting date cannot be behind the end date, as the very complex ones, like this flex contract, valid in this person. I can also show you later on. So now we have, what I said, I would like to have name visible in the list. Our application has different styles. This is a list, the list style, so I can set properties, particularly this list. I could also say, for example, we've given it a label, the slot name. I could also say the label in style list is different. Like all the properties can have a, you can assign it to a style. Yes. Also, for example, above the list you have a filter. Now, the filters. There isn't actually a filter, but you could have a filter, for example, only show me the person from this organization. Also, the filter is a style. So, you're setting the properties, the track match, you can say, okay, this slot is visible in the filter. Also, read, write modes, like this moment. Telephones, this is a phone interface, value, I made a different schema called telephone, and I nested it in this particular slot, and I say the collection is only single, so I can only put a single. Here I have a collection, I say it is multiple. Interface values are also deleted when the parent is deleted. So in this case, the line person is deleted on the telephone part. Employments is also an interface value of a different collection type, called dictionary. See if I have any organizations. Yes, I have one test organization. I can add employments. Now it has an employment with something test. These organizations are created over here. I can add functions. These are also, again, nested values in collection in the collection form. Well, the dictionary. And what is also used quite a lot is a matrix. Here I handle as the vertical elements are all organizations in the system, not only one. And on the right, on the horizontal column, I handle all the functions I have in the system, two. And then with every node, I render a difference. I can render a schema. In this case, I have a schema of only one slot, a Boolean slot. I will go into showing how the code is generated, like creating a matrix with the prompt mask is only 3 lines, but our generator creates maybe 50 lines of code to arrange it all, to have the database ready to do all kinds of constraints, etc. And we have a logging that says who's working on this person, well, I was yesterday and this morning, and yeah. That's a person form. I go back. No, I will show you a bit what happens. A little bit what happens. For example, how small the code created. I can put a break over here. I go back to the name field. Name slot. The result method. What happens? First, we have what we call a class plan. It's just referring to build of plan, method plans that we call for builders. And you have a lot of builders. And for a simple slot like name, you have a getter builder and a setter builder. And then that's what you're seeing right now, a builder, a getter builder, and a setter builder that are added to the plan, the class plan, and the class plan is brought over to the generator. Setter builders. Slots, but unfortunately you do not have the time, and also also, well, much more behavior. Unfortunately, 45 minutes is much shorter as I expected. I really thought I'm running in half an hour. I don't know why, but I thought. There is a panel afterwards. People could ask us questions also. I have also not three advertisements to make. First of all, end the presentation. Tonight is a Possum Cast reception. Probably all heard of it because I sent email to everybody. There is a route description in my bag. I'll put it in the lobby. I would like also to announce a web terminal presentation. We already have a new client server architecture that's not already in production, but it will be presented Thursday at this time. But I heard it was a free slot sooner, but maybe it will be sooner, but it will be on Thursday for sure, given by the families. The last slide also, we are looking for good designers, small technology requisite. The thing about, when you see what we are showing and what we are doing, then please contact us because we are looking for good people. And the last thing, it was my fault, this book wasn't here yesterday, it was in my house, but I brought it this morning, Introduction to Seaside. We only have 20 copies. Are now at the lobby for 18 euros a piece. Interesting book, so if you are interested in buy it. And to end my presentation, I almost forgot, when people come to our reception for the first 30 or 40 people or so, we have SimCom has a little presentation.